Have you received a new project or an assignment and you are planning to prepare a Gantt chart for the same? Maybe you have identified the number of days required to prepare and complete your assignment, and ultimately you may prepare an Excel table, but can you make it presentable and include a properly formatted Gantt chart in your PowerPoint presentations? Do you want to convert this table into something like this, which is more visually appealing and more presentable? Today we are going to prepare a Gantt chart from a very simple set of data. Hi guys, I am Salim Haider from SHK Excel World. If you want to follow along, download the file from the link below. For this particular exercise, we have a list of tasks available here. These tasks relate to preparation of a financial model or a financial feasibility and includes a total of 6 tasks. We have the start date and we have estimated total number of days required to complete each of the tasks. Our target is to first populate all of these columns so that we have enough data to prepare our first draft of the Gantt chart. Ultimately, we will try to make it as dynamic as possible so that it can be used as a template for any project or activity or assignment. As a first step, we will have to calculate the end date because we have the start date and we want to know the duration. So equal to the start date plus the total number of days required to complete the assignment. Just copy this and with the help of shift and down arrow key and control D, we will copy this to all of the rows below. So we have the end date. In order to make this dynamic, we will use formula for inserting current date, that is today, equal to today and empty brackets. Press enter. So it is now showing the current date and we'll copy into the cells below as well. So before applying the formulas for date, days used or days left, we are going to give a hypothetical number to each. I will tell you the reason, because we have to format different bars in the chart, and if the number of days is zero in any case, for example case of days used or in case of days left, we may not be able to see the bar and may not be able to format that bar. So as an estimate, I am just going to give 20 days to each of the days used and the days left and copy it to the whole of the area. Now we are going to insert a stacked bar chart in this, which will ultimately form the basis for or Gantt chart. So go to the insert menu and insert a stacked bar chart by selecting any blank cell. Go to insert, click stacked bar chart. Since we have not selected any data, it is blank. Select the chart and go to the design and select data. Here we are going to insert different series one by one manually and also insert the horizontal category axis. Click add, and for the first series we are going to select the start date because this will actually identify the date when the task is going to start. So series name, start date and series values, all of these. Press OK. Again we are going to insert another series. For this we will need the days used. And for the values, we are going to select all the days used below that. Press OK. Add another series. We will select days left. And in respect of series value, we are again going to select all the values below days left and press OK. For the horizontal category series, 1, 2, 3, 4 is not our required data. Edit this and select the name of all the tasks in your table and press OK. So our first task is coming at the last number, and our last task, which is the revision, is coming at the start. So we need to reverse this order. For this, select the vertical axis, right click, format axis and click category in reverse order. So the order is now fine. We do not need the first series to be visible in our chart. This was just used to identify the start date of each particular task. So before removing this, we are going to do a smart thing. Instead of looking at the vertical axis for identifying each of these tasks, we are going to show this task name in the bars. so that we do not have to refer to vertical axis to identify each of these tasks. So select the series, go to the chart options, select data labels and click more options, and here we can select a different value to be shown on the series by selecting value from cells. In the cell range, we can give the names list here and press OK. Before confirming this, just uncheck the value because we do not want to display the date here. For label positioning, we will select inside end. Now we can remove the filling so that it is not visible in our chart. For this, you can either go here and select no fill, or you can go to the home ribbon and select no fill from here as well. Select the labels. We can change the font to bold so that it is better visible to us. Now we do not need the vertical axis to be visible as these are now appearing against each of the tasks. Just select this and remove this from your chart area. Since all of our tasks are falling within the same financial year, so we do not need to show the years. For this, select the x-axis and go to the axis options. In number, change the format to day and month. We are just going to format each of the tasks with different colors, and then we are going to produce correct formulas for days used and days left. First, we have to change the formatting of the days used series. I am going to select one formatting option, which is the 3D formatting option. So select the series, go to series option, and under 3D format, select the first 3D option available. For changing the color of each of these, one by one, we are going to select each of the series and change its color to our liking. For the days used, I am going to use a dark color, and for the days left, I am going to use a light color. Select the first series so that the other ones are not selected, and select the blue color. For the days left against the first task, I am going to use a light color. Just stay tuned for the next video because we are going to do a lot more changes to this to make this more visually attractive and more informative. Do subscribe to my channel and thanks for watching.